telling every woman in town of the love that he just found. And Marie's the name of his latest flame. He talked and talked, and I heard him say that she had the longest, blackest hair, the prettiest green eyes anywhere. And Marie's the name of his latest flame. Though I smiled, the tears inside were a-burning. I wished him luck and then he said a goodbye. He was gone but still his words kept returning. What else was there for me to do but cry? Would you believe that yesterday this girl was in my arms and swore to me she'd be mine eternally? And Marie's the name of his latest flame. Though I smiled, the tears inside were a-burning. I wished him luck and then he said goodbye. He was gone, but still his words kept returning.
Good morning, Flyers, and welcome back to the Early Bird. I'm your host, Griffin Yarmaloff, and alongside me, as always, is the man, Mr. Shea Curry.
What's up, worms?
We have an amazing episode for you today. We got a full episode, and also we have purple scripts. If anyone knows like where to find printer paper, please email us. But it's going to be a great episode today on the Early Bird. Coming up, we hear from you, but first we have Casey standing live in the studio with an important announcement.
What are you doing? We're live. We're live right now.
We're live now.
We're live right now. Do your thing. We're live.
Where are we live?
From the basement.
Folks, we are live from the basement. It is Thursday morning.
Rodderman, Casey Brewer, Jake Braverman, Logan Shapiro, Jack Desimone.
So, anyway, I just won my fantasy league. Filthy payout.
How much was it?
$20.
Filthy.
The guy I beat was undefeated, too. I think that's a pretty big dub.
No, yeah, that's sick, dude. That's awesome.
You don't seem that excited. You should be ecstatic.
No, yeah, it's just that money isn't really going to me. It just doesn't affect me that much, I guess.
No, I get it. It's not like we haven't been best friends since, like, the first grade.
Are you seriously mad at me, dude? I mean, it's only $20. It's not that much.
Yeah, and that's 20 more hard-earned dollars than you've ever had, pal.
No, but you're acting like it's such a big accomplishment. It was only $20. I mean, what was the buy-in to the league anyways? How many guys are even in it?
Two plus the commissioner.
Two?
Two.
But didn't you just say he was undefeated? And if you're the only other guy in that league, that would mean he beat you 10 times.
Okay, so I lost 10 times against him. That doesn't matter. All that matters is that I won the jackpot.
Yeah, the $20 jackpot.
You know what? Why do I even tell you this stuff? Just be happy for me.
I am happy for you, but... You can go spend your winnings on half a t-shirt now. That's awesome.
What's that supposed to mean?
That's supposed to mean that the money you made from fantasy isn't enough for a stupid t-shirt.
Have I ever told you that you're a bad friend, Zach?
All the time. I'm sorry, but why would you do a two-man league? What fun is that? It's just two of you!
You know what? I'm done with this. Don't call me. Don't come by my house. We're done.
What?
Jack, you have some nerve showing up here. Zach, move over.
Oh, hey, Logan, what's up?
What's up is that I lost $20 because of you, Jack. You cheated.
Wait, you cheated? That is comical. How do you even cheat in fantasy football?
Taking my phone and trading every single one of my players to himself. In the finals, no less.
That's not how I remember it.
Sounds like Jack, to be honest.
I can't believe you don't believe me. Go call up Jake and watch him deny Logan's allegations.
You know what? Fine. Sup, Jake?
What's up, G?
Please, just tell me what you think happened in the fantasy finals.
Not this again. Man, it's just $20. Just leave it alone.
Only $20. Only $20. Says the man who still has $20. Do you know what that could have bought for me?
Well, maybe half a t-shirt?
Half a t-shirt.
Doesn't look like we have an answer, does it?
We do have an answer. That's that he cheated.
Look, if you'll get you a shot, I'll pay you a stinking $20 worth of Crocs, all right? That's like 2/5 of a shoe.
Deep breaths, deep breaths, deep breaths. I am leaving. Congrats on the finals, Jack.
That's funny. I'm gonna move back to my seat. So you cheated, right?
Oh, yeah, I thought you knew that.
Coming up, we hear from you, but now live in the studio with the pledge is Raymond.
This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me.
Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Raymond. It's time to kick it over to the announcements.
Hey, good morning, Flyers. I don't think I've seen you since last year. I think that's pretty crazy. I hope you had a great break. And I also wanted to let you know that if you ordered one of the sweatshirts that Megan's wearing right now, they are available for pickup in Ito 6 before or after school, so go do that. And also, there's actually going to be a junior class fundraiser at Chipotle next Tuesday, January 11th, next Tuesday on January 11th, after school at Chipotle. So when you go there on Tuesday, January 11th, mention that you're there for the class of 2023 at FHS. Thank you.
Hi, yearbooks are still for sale, so make sure to get yours before time runs out. Seniors, your quotes are due by the end of next week, so just try to get those in as soon as possible. Thank you.
Happy New Year, FHS. So the GSA is meeting today. Awesome. It's going to be mostly a check-in meeting, as well as we're going to be going over some like future leadership roles for the club. It's going to be a little shorter than usual, maybe like 30 minutes or so. Like I said, just like check in. How's everyone doing? Awesome? Great. You can go. I don't know. So have a nice day, and we'll see you in B106 after school.
Good morning, everyone. I just wanted to check in to let you know that I've definitely seen an improvement with the proper mask wearing, so thank you all very much for that. Please keep up the great work. We are going to be sending some correspondence home, though, for students who habitually fail to wear their mask properly and what the expectations and consequences are going to be for that. Now, for the vast majority of students, you're doing an amazing job, but we have some students who still struggle with the proper mask wearing. So please be vigilant about that and be on the lookout for that correspondence. Mid-year exams. I sent out the schedule. I hope everyone received it. What I'm concerned about a little bit, though, is that in your planner, it does not match the mid-year exam schedule. And so on the 13th of January through the 21st, what's in your planner is incorrect. So the 13th is a regular day 5. The 14th is a regular day 6, and then the following week, the 17th, you're off because that's a holiday. Beginning the 18th, two exams each day, 18, 19, and 20, dismissal at 10:45, and then on Friday the 21st, one exam, dismissal at 9 o'clock, and you can have a makeup exam at 9 o'clock, provided that it has been pre-approved by your teacher. So we'll post this in the windows also of the main office just so you have easy access to it, but I just want you to disregard what is in your planner on those dates. The other thing I think most of you know by now, an announcement came out from the district about student activities, athletics, fine and performing arts, clubs, late buses. All of that has been canceled through the 21st of January due to the uptick in COVID. So I know it's disappointing, but in to keep everyone safe, that decision was made at the district level. So I just wanted to reiterate that we will not have late buses beginning. This all begins Friday. No late buses, student activities, athletics, fine and performing arts, et cetera. In the Heights has also been postponed as well, hopefully to early February. So with that, if you have any questions, drop by my office, send me an email. I'll be happy to meet with anyone who wants to talk. And now I'm going to send it back to Griffin and Shea. Have a great day.
That's all for today's episode of The Early Bird. If you enjoyed this episode and you want to watch it again, you can find it on our YouTube or in our Instagram bio at Framingham High Studios. Have a great day, Flyers. And remember, it's Thursday. It's like the Friday of Friday. So, like, get hyped. We're almost at the end of the week. And remember, the early bird gets the worm. Deserve it, call me crazy.